Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make this quick and easy checklist in Canva. So I'm in the Canva homepage, and I'm going to go to Create Design and down to A4 Document. First thing I'm going to do is to insert the table. So I'm going to go to Elements, and then at the top here, I can search Table, press Enter, and you can see I have a range of tables to choose from. I'm just going to click this first one here, and by default I'll get a 3x4 table. When you hover over any of the rows or columns, you'll see there's three dots. If you click on that, you'll see you have a number of different customization options. Now, because I want 8 columns, I'm going to add a column here, and I'm going to continue to do that until I have 8 columns. I'm now going to just stretch out this table to as wide as I want it. And then I have to consider how wide I want this first column to put in my tasks. So I'm going to gently just move all of these row lines over, all these column lines over. And if I only need about this much space, then I make sure that this line is around about here, but I can move it to the left or the right to ensure that I have enough space for my tasks. So I now want to make all of these columns equal. So I'm going to select this bottom right row, hold down my shift key and click on this top one here, then go to the three dots and go down to size columns equally. And now all my columns are equal. So now I'm just going to move my table up round about here, and then I'm going to go down to the bottom and I'm going to click on these three dots here and add rows. And I'm going to continue to do that until I fill my page with rows. Now, you don't have to have this many rows. You can have as many as your tasks. It's completely up to you. We can just have some for notes at the end. Perfect. So once I've done that, I'm going to go into these top rows here and just put in my days of the week initials. And then down here, I'm just going to type in my tasks. So I'm just going to put task one. Now you can see it's centered, but I want all of my tasks to be over and aligned to the left. So select this top cell here, hold down the shift key and click at the bottom. Go up to the alignment tool here and just click once. It will make sure everything's over to the left-hand side. And then I'm just going to put in the rest of my tasks. Perfect. So let's just deselect it and check it. That's great. So just select that table, go to position, and then just check it's centered. If it's grayed out, it means it's perfectly centered. And then we just need to put the title in. So let's go over to text, grab this heading text and click and drag it over. Just move it over to the center. You'll know it's centered because it will click into place and there will be this pink line that runs vertically. So let's change the heading to checklist. And then I'm going to change the font to playlist script. I'm just going to pull that out to make sure it's the right size. Let's just move that back to the center again and deselect. Let's go over and get a few elements of graphics. So we go to elements here and then down to graphics, click see all, up to the graphics here, and we'll just type in foliage, press enter. I haven't spelled it right. There we go. Click and drag this one across, or any one of your choices, lots to choose from. I'm going to click and drag this one across. I'm going to just put it over the top of the table. I quite like it like that. Hold down your Alt or Option key once you've selected the foliage, click and drag, and it will copy and paste that foliage for you. Let's just turn that round and then move that up to there. Maybe make this a little bit smaller so we can see more of it. Perfect. Now I want to change the background, so I'm going to go up to Elements and go to Lines and Shape, click and drag across a background color or a background rectangle. And I'm just going to literally stretch that across my page like that. You can see it's covered everything up, so I need to send it to the back so to allow everything to show through. So select it, go to position and click on To Back. Now you can see everything's showing through. I'm now going to select my table and go up to color, click on it, and I'm going to change my table to white. Now that's just changed one cell. So I'm going to select that cell, hold down my shift key and click on the bottom right cell. Again, go back up to color and click on white. Perfect. Now we're just going to put a white border around the outside of the table. So again, to elements, down to the lines and shapes and click, and we've got that rectangle. Now we don't want to lose it to the background, it's the same color, so I'm going to customize it now. Select it, go up to the border style and border weight, I'm going to drag over to around about 15. Border color here, I'm going to make white, and the shape color here, I'm going to make transparent. Just resize this by clicking and dragging out the corners. You can give it as much or as little space as you want. But to ensure these are both centered to each other, I'm just going to move the background. Because if I try and select both of those elements, you can see I just keep clicking on the background. So just move the background out of the way for 2 seconds. Click and drag across these two elements. And you can see just those two are now selected. Go to position and then center it, and also to the middle. And that will perfectly center those two elements. Perfect. Now just move the background back into place. The final thing is just to bring this foliage forward. So select it, go to position, and then click on to front. Perfect. Once you're happy with your design, you just need to go up to share. You can either copy a link or you can download the file here in download. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.